So we've all heard stories of people who've gone on cruises and gained 10 pounds fat in a week. You don't have to do that. It's stupid. A cruise ship is a great opportunity to lose body fat. Now, don't get me wrong. I want you to be able to eat anything you want on the boat and enjoy your cruise. That's what this is about. You're on vacation. Of course, you're going to eat some fabulous food. But what I'm going to show you here is how you can still have all those fabulous foods, but not overeat and gain 10 pounds. The way we're going to do this is we're going to have multiple courses. We're going to start with a salad course. The salad course is going to fill us up. We're going to make a nice healthy salad. We're going to sit down and eat it before we take anything else. That's going to give our stomach a chance to fill up with some healthy vegetables. And then when we go back for all the things we want, we'll end up taking smaller portions because we're not starved anymore. The key to losing weight on a cruise ship is to start every meal with a salad. Let's go down the salad bar. I'm going to show you things that you can have. A lot of people from the Midwest in America tend to think of salad as something goofy with salad dressing, like potato salad or macaroni salad. That is not what I'm talking about. The key here is vegetables, fresh vegetables. So, this is good, greens, but spinach is even better. We're going to go with the spinach. The great thing about salad bars on ships is they've done all the work for you. They've done all the shopping and the preparing. A lot of you say you don't like vegetables. Well, this is a great time to try new stuff. So, I like to go with the colorful stuff. So I'm going to go with the bell peppers over here. All this stuff is very low calorie. So this is a great way to get all kinds of vitamins and antioxidants without filling you up. There's a lot of fiber, so it fills you up without calories. Again, we're going to go for the bright stuff. So I got the bell peppers. I'm going to go with some cucumbers there. Cabbage is really good. Carrots. Tomatoes. Now this is a huge plate of food. And there's hardly any calories here. This isn't more than 50 calories. So let's continue down the line. So here's what we want to avoid. Most people pile on the goopy dressing. This is hundreds and hundreds of calories. No goopy dressing. The only thing you can put on is vinegar. We'll show you the vinegar. Here's some more things you want to avoid. Bacon is not something you want to put on. Anchovies, way too much salt. These croutons are just fat and simple carbs. So we're avoiding that. The Parmesan, we're going to skip that. So there's nothing here. I mean, we're going to skip the iceberg lettuce too. So after we've had our yummy salad, we go back for the main course. Now, before you start scooping up food, you need to walk around and see everything that's available. Plan what you're going to have before you start piling food on your plate. Because a lot of times what happens, you know, you see something you like, you put it on your plate, and then, you know, when you've had have as much food as you want on your plate, you say, oh my God, there's that, I love that. And you end up putting that on your plate too, and you end up eating it all because you don't like wasting food. That's how you're going to gain 10 pounds. So walk around, look at everything that's available before you start putting stuff on your plate. So start by choosing your protein source. Most of you have a pretty good idea what the correct portion size is to get 30 to 40 grams protein. If not, you know, get online to nutritiondata.com or someone else and figure out how much of chicken, fish, beef, lamb, or whatever you're eating it takes to get that 30 to 40 grams. It's a great time to learn portion size. And, you know, don't have huge portions. Just have enough to satisfy yourself. After you have, you can go back as many times as you want, right? There's no reason that you have to pile it on the first time. So choose your protein source and then choose some sides that look good. You know, if you want some goopy, cheesy things, that's fine, but just have a little.
And because you had your salad already, you're not going to be that hungry. So that is the reason we have that salad first. So go ahead, sit down, eat your main course with the sides, but don't put dessert on your plate. Again, you don't want to do that at this point. Sit down, eat your main course, because what you're going to find, when you've eaten your salad, you've eaten your main course, by the time it comes to dessert, you're probably going to be too full to eat anything. If you're not, then have a little fruit. If you really, really need sweets, have a very small portion. You know, it's all about portion control. Enjoy it, but portion control. So anyway, that is how to survive a cruise buffet without gaining 10 pounds. Actually, I lost some weight while I was on the cruise. That is it for this week. Thanks for joining me. Auf Wiedersehen.